Welcome to Sleepless Readings. Tonight we'll be reading a tale called I Jumped Out of Line in Hell.
Every human being you have known, every person you've ever seen, will or has died. Eventually death comes for all of us. I figured I would die an old man, happy and content, but I didn't. When I died, I was miserable and full of hate. I'd been working for a loan shark. Muscle. If you didn't pay, you had to see me. It was a terrible job and I regret it now, but that didn't matter. I was shot. Mugged for the 18 bucks in my goddamn wallet. Twice in the chest, 9mm. Shot down in the rain. I felt myself hit the ground, staring up at the night sky. No bright light. I felt myself begin to fade, darkness creeping in on me as the masked gunman took my wallet, sprinting off into the night. My vision became blurred as finally darkness fell onto me. Then I was nowhere. I wasn't anywhere. Like being asleep, but not dreaming. Almost conscious, just in complete darkness, unable to move. I could not tell you how long I was like that. 2 hours? 3 hours? 10 hours, a day, I don't know. But after a very long time, I felt solid ground beneath my feet. I began walking, and I opened my eyes for the first time, and I could see a bright yellow light at the end of this darkness. Oh my god, this is it. Heaven, it's real, I'm here, it's... I came to the end of a light, finding myself in front of these massive stone gates. I'd walked out of a stone tunnel with thousands of people lined up in front of them. All different races, men, women, everyone. At the front of this massive queue was two men, one wearing red and white robes with black hair and a beard, and the other clean-shaven, blonde, wearing armor. Nobody was speaking, except for the two men at the front. I don't think they were able to, as I couldn't speak either, even when I tried. I waited in that line for an hour. They were moving through them quite quickly. I could hear what they were saying as I walked towards the front of a line. One of the men was speaking Italian or maybe Latin, I don't know. And the other was translating into whatever language that person spoke. I saw him speak to one woman in English.
He says your soul has been measured and you have been accepted into the kingdom of God.
The woman nods, walking forward through the gates. The next man, the man in red and white, speaks again, and then the armored man says,
Hanser alvidit latsan, mendichal hamats, oktaha enta acceptarat si gotsrike.
The look of fear in that man's eyes I'll never forget. He walked down a flight of stairs that was to the right of the entrance of the gates. Not so long after that, I was up. The man in red and white said something in Latin Italian, and the armored man said,
Peter says he is very sorry, but your soul has been measured and you have not been accepted into the kingdom of God.
I try to argue, but I can't speak. I feel my feet walking away from the two men down a flight of stairs. I can see the man from before walking down ahead of me. I know I'm descending to hell. I know that, but I can't stop moving. The stone brick steps are illuminated with metal torches on the walls. I can feel the heat rising as I descend. As I reach the bottom, it is sweltering. I sweat through my t-shirt, my head dripping with sweat. The stench of burning meat and sulfur is unbearable. I look up and see an ocean of fire whirlpooling ever down. Standing off to the side are terrifying creatures that immediately I identified as being demons. These beasts were things I couldn't imagine. Deformed. Pieces of animals where pieces of animals should not be. Teeth and eyes everywhere. One of them had razor-sharp fangs jutting out of his lopsided mouth. Most of them had a human quality to them as well, which made them all the more disturbing. They began speaking to each other in words that would be unpronounceable for me. One of them had the head of some kind of big cat, but it was deformed and it almost looked like it had melted slightly. Blood oozing out of every orifice on its face. Razor-sharp teeth jutted down from above, connecting to a horrible, almost human body with the leatheriest of dark green skin. These massive hands grabbed both my legs and began dragging me across the hot stones. I was brought to a sort of corral with a bunch of other humans fenced in behind a petrified wood fence. I could hear people around me screaming, and that was how I figured out I could move and speak again. We were surrounded by the demons. There was no way of escape. They kept us corralled, not speaking a word of English, only speaking in whatever tongue they were speaking. Words I can't physically say. They waited and watched until they apparently decided they were ready. We were once again grabbed by demons. The same horrible big cat demon grabbing me by my arms this time and dragging me from this fenced area. My skin legitimately burning just touching these rocks. Some people cry out and try to struggle away from these demons, but not me. I was fighting, kicking, trying to break free, but I could not. Its grip was too strong, and it was fazed by my attacks. It brought us to a large stone platform. They began to place us in lines. He never made any verbal commands to us, but they would literally hold us so we would stand. And after a while, they would leave and we would just stay there. They seemed to be discussing what to do with us. Their mouths never moved, and the sound that they were making was indecipherable. I wasn't gonna take it lying down. As they spoke, I ran back towards the corral where we had just been. I didn't dare look behind me. I knew they were there, but I couldn't bring myself to look behind me. They were right there. I made it back out towards the steps and where I had first been grabbed by the demon. There were more people coming down the steps. I ran up the steps, knocking past the people stuck walking down the steps. I didn't intend to, but as they stood up, they were no longer stuck. They were able to move on their own, and they were terrified. I didn't care. Demons were chasing me. I continued up these steps. Up these steps. So many goddamn steps. I reached the top, and there, St. Peter and the armored man. They look at me. Peter begins to yell at me in Italian Latin. I back away, running back towards the stone tunnels I entered through. I ran away from the light of the afterlife. I keep running back into the black, back into the abyss, and then bam, I'm back on that street corner. I'm looking at my body. Two holes in my chest, leaking a quart of blood on the ground. Lightly, I can hear the siren of an ambulance growing in the background. But then suddenly, everything goes silent. Everything is frozen. The rain drops in the air. Suddenly I turn, and I can see a man in a flat cap, a button-up shirt, and, like, khakis.
You really should not be here.
His voice was low, sort of raspy, like he smoked a pack a day. What the hell are you talking about? I'm dead. I was just in hell. How the hell am I here? The man laughed.
Buddy, I got news for you. You might live. The only reason you escaped those hell things is because you might live.
What? I thought God had a plan for me. How is there a might? What you mean by might? I was angry. I wasn't messing around.
Well, I'm Death, or Ankau, Smerik, Yama. I help guide people like you to transition through life, death, and afterlife. Not always in that order. You're an exception. Look, I got it wrong. You were supposed to live, but I sent your soul to Peter and his boy at the gates. I made a mistake. I'm here to set it straight. But, now you're back here, so no harm done. We'll get you back into your broken body and we can all be on our way and this can just be a coma dream.
He snapped at me and nodded.
Okay, you ready to go back into your body again?
What? No, of course not. I have so many questions. Does this mean I'm going to hell no matter what when I die? I couldn't. No, surely I'd come back from this.
No. You can always change before you die next, but I can't tell you when that's gonna be, so that could be tomorrow. Good luck.
A doorway appeared to the left of me. And I just go through there? I looked at him.
You just walk through there.
I nodded. I walked up to the door and grabbed the handle, twisting it open. Inside was that same black void. I stepped into it and suddenly I was awake in an hospital room. It was totally the middle of day sunshine coming through the windows. The doctors explained what happened to me. I already knew, but they didn't care. I didn't try to tell anyone what I saw. They'd say I was a schizoid for life. So, I hid it. That was 10 years ago. I've changed my life. Become a better person. I've taken steps to be better. I haven't been violent at all. I quit my loan shark job. I pray that when I die, I get to go through the gates, because what I saw in hell torments my nightmares to this day. Maybe I'm crazy. Or maybe I really saw beyond what the living was ever supposed to see.
Thank you for listening. That was I Jumped Out of Line in Hell.
Don't forget to like the video. It does help to boost the channel.
Leave a comment for the algorithm.
There's new stories every Sunday.
Not to mention the shorts on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
So subscribe.
And ring the bell.
Thanks, guys. And as always,
stay sleepless.